And then I was thinking, well, you know, here's a way you could soak up some of that oil in the BP oil spill. Here's what you could use. You could use some tea baggers. Tea baggers. Is there no gay man in the Republican Party that might have said to them, maybe not that phrase? And it turns out there was a gay man in the Republican Party, Ken Melman. And now he's out of power, has no influence, and he comes out. Thank you so much. Good timing. That's why I've invented the Ken Melman app. And it tells you when it's past time to come out. And in my house, my girlfriend will not allow me to call the teabaggers stupid. I know, she just gets so upset. She said, you can't call them stupid. But they are stupid. She said, it doesn't matter, you can't call them stupid. The teabaggers are, I guess, here to stay. I don't agree with anything they say, but I defend their right to say it, unlike them, toward me. I didn't think I agreed with anything they say, and then I was listening to them the other day, watching them, and I thought, well, maybe we do agree on one thing. And that is that there might not be such a thing as evolution. Archaeologists are, and are there any archaeologists here before I go on? Because, oh God, because I read widely, but not deeply. They found a dinosaur from 14,000 years ago, and they're like, no, that's not a dinosaur. That is not a dinosaur toe at all. That is a croissant. They just found the skeletal remains from 4 million years ago of a female figure called Ardi. Isn't that wonderful? And I think she's a lesbian. If you see her Facebook page, you would know. Likes upright walks in the jungle. There she is, right there. And it turns out we carbon dated at one point. But anyway, and scientists have just figured out that way back when, that there might have been some mingling with the Homo sapiens and the Neanderthals, which I think explains a lot. I think it explains this drive to return to a Palinolithic time. Sarah Palin. America's sweetheart. She is like the life coach from hell. I mean, she really gives narcissism a bad name. Have you seen her Alaska reality show? Sarah Palin's Alaska. It's freaky. And in it, it is revealed again that her totem is the mama grizzly. She is the girl with the bear tattoo. Less Stieg Larsson and more Gary Larsson, don't you feel? But the thing that really galls me about Sarah Palin is that she calls herself a feminist. And she has a fundraising group called the Susan B. Anthony List. That would be as if I put on a yellow wig and started talking like Ann Coulter. I know, but I had this dream the other day. I woke up and I was in the middle of this nightmare, and in the nightmare, Ann Coulter was going down on me. I know, I thought anything to shut her up. But in my house, I am not allowed to call this teahottest stupid. She says I'm just jealous of the teabaggers. Yeah, because they're heavily funded. The Koch brothers and Dick's Army, whatever. They have their own media outlets. They have Fox News. They have the Wall Street Journal. And if you want an immigrant who's done so much damage to this country, let's take Rupert Murdoch for an example. And that the teabaggers are actually destroying the Republican Party. She says you're jealous. And maybe she's right. I am a little green. It's a green show. No, but she won't allow me to call them stupid, and it really cramps my style. But when I was growing up, we were not allowed to call anybody stupid. We weren't allowed to tell anybody to shut up. And if you swore, you got your mouth washed out with soap. So I ate a lot of lava as a child. I was foaming at the mouth most of my childhood. And it really cramped my style. When I was little, in first grade, I was heavily into anti-bullying. Before the wonderful work that GLSEN has done, the wonderful work that GLAAD has done, the It Gets Better campaign, and I get bitter. But even when I was in first grade, I was a major anti-bullier. There was a bully in my class, and he used to wail on this little kid in my class. And I had a red plaid lunch pail with a red plaid thermos in it, and I would just wail on him, just knock him out. I liked to do it before lunch when the thermos was still full. And one day I was a little too eager and knocked him out. Just out cold, and I got sent to the principal's office. Now, this was in my little Catholic grammar school, Our Lady of Psychological Warfare. Many graduates are here. And so I got sent to the principal's office. Now, this was a big, big nun. Her name was Sister Mary Top. And I was fascinated. Like, what do you do with the rope? Okay. But they told her what I had done, that I had taken this kid out, and she let me go because she hated the kid too.